Hello and welcome to the Vector Garden YouTube channel. My name is Monika, and in this video I'm going to talk about a very obscure option in Illustrator. Opacity and mask define knockout shape. Now, you might have come across it and maybe you've asked yourself, well, what does that even do? In order to talk about this option, we first have to talk about another thing, which this option is a part of, and that's knockout groups. So I've prepared some artwork here to talk about knockout groups. Now, this design has some overlaying elements like this. And of course, when I prepare this, I'm using a gray fill inside of this object. And naturally, this overlays the other things, and I can still edit it and move it around and just play with it. But what if I want to overlay that on this kind of object? Or what if I want to take this whole thing and move it like here? In order to be able to do that, I would have to cut out some things and, you know, knock them out or make masks. And then it would be very difficult to edit this. When, after cutting this, I want to move this one slightly to the right, that won't be possible. So I want to make this in a kind of fashion that it stays editable as long as even possible. And to do that, we can use knockout groups. In order to prepare this for a knockout group, what you need to do is select one of those. These elements are grouped. You see it in the layers panel, so they consist of several parts, and there's some lines that have just strokes and some have strokes and fills. And I have to select the ones that have the gray fills. So I select one of them and then go to select same fill color. And then I have selected all those with the gray fills and go to window appearance. And there is that gray fill, and I'm going to set its opacity to 0. So it's now gone. Now, this is not so impressive. I have to select it all and then go to Object Group. And now comes the magic, the knockout group. I'm going into the transparency panel and show the options. And there we have the knockout group, and this needs to be checked. So I need to click again. It's checked, and there we have the knockout group. It looks like before, but now it's different because I can now take it and move it up there. You might notice that the pattern in this behaves kind of strange, so we're going to fix that as well. And I'm going into the Illustrator preferences in general, and then I check transform pattern tiles, and then the pattern won't do that again. So I can move it now like this. What you might also notice is there's some kind of ugly border. You can fix that as well by going to view preview on CPU. So now I can use it on the gradient as well, or on patterns, or whatever. It's now nice, and I can still edit it easily because I can now, you know, change it like that and the knockout stays. So that's nice. So the knockout group allows us to keep these designs easily editable and still be able to see them and present them and just have them look like the final artwork. Now, you already have seen that here is our obscure option. Opacity and mask define knockout shape. Now, what does that do now? when talking about this kind of options in Illustrator, we might think in a different way about them, because usually when you turn on some option, then you enable something. So this option is different in two things. One of them is when you apply it, you don't select this complete thing and then check this option. And the other thing is it doesn't enable something, it disables something. Let's take a look at that. Now let's pretend that in the case of this object, I don't want to knock out completely. What I want instead is, let's go to the gradient panel and let's apply a gradient. So I'm going to apply this gradient to it. And then I'm going to make it like this, and that stop has 0%, like that. So this is now the gradient, and what we're going to do is in the appearance panel also, I'm going to set the opacity to 100% again, like so. And what I want this gradient to be is that it shouldn't knock out the pattern, but the pattern should be visible in that gradient, at least partly. So at the moment, that gradient, since there is 0% inside that gradient stop, it still knocks out partly. So I have to disable the knockout group in this object. So I'm going to select just that object inside the group, inside the other group, and let's turn on that option. And there you see it. What we're doing is that the knockout group is still active in the other elements, but not inside this one. We have excluded that one element from the knockout group. Everything is still editable, and using the knockout group plus this option for selected elements, we can build even more complex designs but have them still stay editable without having to use masking or cutting or other things. So when building your designs, you can now use more options and stay editable longer, which is what Illustrator is all about. Happy designing! If you liked the video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. See you next time.